Hello everybody, welcome to my channel, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting, and today I'm coming to share with you how you can change this DVD or CD stand, it's stand like this, to something maybe more useful, especially for crafters, for some organizer like this. It has many pockets, and you can organize in those pockets, and in those pockets you can organize your photographs, your recipes, or tags for journals, pockets for journals, and it's not too hard. It's just few steps. So I'm gonna share with you how I made it. First, what you have to do is measure your pocket, the size you need. I guess they will be all same because all CDs are exactly same. So what I did measure this top, then I did measure this gap here and size, how deep or how high my pockets will be. So for this stand, which has 7 and 5/8 from here to here, 3.5 from here to the top, and it has 3/4 inch. I did cut cards for this stand. I needed 27 cards to make it full pocket organizer, and I did cut cards 9.5 by 6. So I used 12 by 12 decorative papers, and I cut many of them to the size 9.5 to 6. I also saved those offcuts because with them I'm gonna make my tags for those pockets. Then you need to take scoring tool and score your card 1 inch, twist it, 2.5 inches, twist it again, 1 inch, and then 2 3/4 and 6 6 5/8, and then move it again and score here 1/2 inch just to that first score line, and flip it over and score again. Just find with your finger, if you will have dark paper like me, find with your finger where is that 1 inch score line and score 1/2 inch again. That's all about scoring. It will look like this when you will have all score line done. So first will be 1 inch, twist it, 2.5 inches, twist it again, 1 inch, then 2 3/4 and 6 5/8, and then those 1/2 and 1/2. Fold those score lines, those straight score lines, fold them. Take your scissors, and we're gonna cut this small corner here. This piece here, like this, and here where I do have those score lines, I'm cutting like around those score lines. I'm making small gap and I'm making those this small gap for those wires, to fold that paper over those wires. And again, around that score line. Cut this corner. And this corner. That's all cutting you need to do. If you are a crafter like me, and if you like to make junk journals, save your pieces for tags, You can decorate your tux with those pieces. Now I'm going to, because I like that curly shape, that soft shape of those corners. So I'm gonna cut those top corners like this. And if you like vintage style, use distress ink and distress that piece, your pocket. So you will have piece like this. And now when you will choose what you would like to see from that paper, this white side or this side, then place it on your table, fold those scored pieces, and put double-sided tape on those pieces. Sorry, I had to stop my camera. Oh, but because I would like to have to see this white piece, I'm gonna do it this way. I would like to see my pockets like this. I do have all of them done, so they will be behind each other like this, so I will see that white side. So put double-sided tape here in this middle piece, and here. And also on those side pieces. I'm gonna cut pieces like this here. And here. That's all you need to do. And you have prepared your pockets or boxes. And now we will start to work with our pieces. And I forgot to say, and I didn't save any. You can use first one without double-sided tape. So one keep without the double-sided tape. You will don't need that for one, for that last one. This, with this fold, will be on the end of my table. So it will be around the corner of my table. It will be like hand. So I'm gonna start from here, which will be back of my drawer, of my organizer. And you just need to place it there like this. Then take your second pocket. Place it. Oh, sorry. You didn't see that. Okay. I'm gonna move. I'm sorry. You didn't see that. I'm going again. So take your first piece and put it to your DVD stand like this. Take second piece. Slide it to second divider, and from the start it will be a little bit tricky, but it's just, I think, two or three pockets, just those first, you know, it's a little bit tricky. So those first pockets can be tricky, but if you will flip it this way, you can leave it on your table and you can manage that much better. So what is important to make nice pockets? First, what I found that it's very useful. With your eye, try to continue from this wire to this wire in some kind of good corner, good shape. Then move this first pocket and this one, just fold down. And that's why I'm using double-sided tape. I have tried that with tacky glue And it was terrible. I had to wait until it's dry. It was really terrible. So for that, I'm using now double-sided tape. It's much more easy, much more fast. Flip it over and again. Prepare your side. Like this. With this, try to follow the wire. With this one, try to follow that line of wire and make some nice corner and fold this one. Make sure you will move this pocket to the wire. Otherwise, you will have, you know, it will be not sitting properly. Like this. Glue it. And now this. Take it off. Like this. And second. Like this. Flip it over. Lift up this piece. Take off the cover of your double-sided tape. Like this. Make sure it's moved to the to touching those wires and glue it down. Take another pocket. Where are my pockets? Here. And again. Slide it to next spot. Like this. Here. Ooh, go there. And here. First, it's good to follow the wire, that wire shape. So lift it up. Make that line. And glue it. Like this. Do that other side. Exactly same. And I think here I put my double-sided tape too far, so I'm gonna put that a little bit more here. Follow with that pocket, follow that line of your wire, of that wire. Oh, postman. He's waving on me. Now those bottom pieces. And always like move it to the end. And fold it together. Like this. Flip it over. Lift this up, take off the piece from that double-sided tape. Again, make sure it's close to those wires and glue it down. Continue with all those pieces this way. Once you reach the needle end, you've got nearly all pockets. It's just two pockets I have to put there. So take that one, place it to the space it's supposed to be, move it to the end, to close to those wires, and make a mark where is that last wire. Take it off. And you will need to cut it out, this piece. So take a paper guillotine or trimmer. I'm gonna take my trimmer. Where is my mark? Here is my mark. And I'm gonna cut all these three at the size I draw here. Here I draw that line. So I'm gonna, I guess here. Hey, whoops. So many things around me. Now slide it in. I'm gonna take off that double-sided tape. Oh, this is too small. I'm gonna take it off straight away. From here. Probably from here as well. Hey, come here, come here. Come here, come on. Yikes. Like this. Slide it in. Move it to the wires. I need to move my camera a little bit. It can't be moved too much, I'm sorry. And press it down. Fold those small. Glue them to the end for this one. Now sides. And always try all that way down. Try to press that down to make sure you are copy the shape of that wire, the line of that wire. Like this. The other side, take it off. Pull it down to the wire, pull down this one to the wire to make sure you've got all in good shape. Press it together. And now that last piece. I hope it will not fall down again. And I hope you will see what I'm doing. I need to cut this a little bit. But just this middle part. That I will cut by eye. Just probably on half. We're gonna take off this piece of double-sided tape, lift this middle a little bit up and slide it in as much as you can to those wires. Way, lift it up, slide it in. Hey, go there. Am I there? Yes, I am. I'm there. Oh, not yet. Okay, I slide that right, but I move that rest as well. So I have to move it back a little bit. All that rest. Sorry. Sorry for that, guys. I hit my camera stand. So this is probably the worst thing. I'm gonna cut it a little bit more with my scissors. Because it will be saved with those other hints as well. So I think I don't need too big space. Like this. And now those other pieces. And just hold it, this fold to the wire, and glue it together here. Same it will be on this side. take that off. Move this to the wire and glue it together, and same will be on the bottom with those pieces. Like this and like this, and you have a base. You have a base like this with many pockets, and on the embellishment on on those sides, I have prepared those pieces. I do have a few of those Amazon book boxes, so I used that box, and I cut pieces 3.5 inches wide on those sides and long as it's all those pockets, two of them, those two, then one piece to cover this bottom like this, and two pieces for this end and here. And now I'm going to glue it together. Hopefully I will be successful. So first I'm gonna glue those front and back piece. This will be my front, the front of my drawer. I move camera a little bit to make sure you will see. So this will be front of my drawer. I have here a piece 3.5 by, I think this is 7.5, and because this fits perfectly, I'm gonna use tacky glue, and I will put tacky glue here on this pocket, all over that pocket. I'm gonna make sure it's everywhere. And glue it, same I'm gonna do on that opposite side. For the bottom and for the sides, I'm gonna use hot glue gun, and I'm gonna glue those three sides as well. And finally, once you have all your sides done, you can decorate it with some pictures or with anything you want, with some embellishments. I choose those vintage pictures. And I put already some of my tags inside. Here some photographies. Pretty dark already. So you will see just this one. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you will try it if you have those stands. And I hope you like it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. And see you next time. Bye.